a discussion on women in leadership with Gloria Felt, former president and CEO of Planned Parenthood and author of No Excuses, 9 Ways Women Can Change How We Think About Power.
Hi there. I am so happy to be here. This is the most amazing book festival I have ever seen. It is fabulous. Fabulous. Congratulations to all of you. Sometimes what you think is your liability in life turns out to be the greatest asset that you have. What you need, the resource that you need to do almost anything, is right there in your hands, if you can see it and if you can have the courage to use it. But let me assure you, I did not start from a place of power. A 16-year-old new mom does not start from a place of power. The thing is that everywhere we look, people are telling us it is women's moment. Women are 54% of the voters. We are 17% of Congress. If we stay at the current rate, it will take us 70 years to get to parity. I found from my research that women resist the power that's in our hands. So what I wanted to do as a practical activist all my life is to share what I learned from my own life on the front lines of leadership and what I learned from talking with women all over the country is that controversy is actually your friend. If something is controversial, it means you're important. I learned to embrace controversy. I learned to love. How many of you love controversy? I knew there'd be a few here. Carpe the chaos. The truth is that when things are in chaos, that's when you can actually make the change you want to make. And wearing the shirt of our convictions is one of the most singularly important and effective leadership skills. The media forms us as it informs us. And women have a huge opportunity now in the leadership realm in social media. I mean, we've just seen in Egypt what social media can do. It can change the world. Women are 60% of the social media users. So, what are we talking about on social media? Where's our Tahrir Square? It's time.
What advice would you have for young women that are just starting and, you know, they have good ideas, they want to create change at work, but their bosses, they're pessimistic, they tell you, well, that's the way it's been done.
You know, if you can apply those principles of be a sister, reach out to somebody else if you think she needs help, and ask for help when you need it. Get your sisters together and brothers who feel the same way, and go try to make it happen. It probably will. After I had left my 30-year career with Planned Parenthood and I realized I had allowed the movement to subsume me and who I was, I listened to my father's words and I realized he was right. I really could do anything my pretty little head desired.